Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about the quality. What is quality? Quality is nothing but it is the ongoing process of building and sustaining relationships by assessing, anticipating and fulfilling stated and implied needs. In other words, quality can be defined as quality is the extent to which products, services, processes, and relationships are free from defects, constraints, and items which do not add value for customers. It can be easily defined as it is the customer's perception of the value of the supplier's work output. Means, quality is nothing but the customer satisfaction towards the product he is going to buy. What is quality management? Quality management is the process which is related to keep watch on all activities or processes that must be undertaken for accomplishment to achieve desired outcome. For proper quality management, determination of quality policy is the prior and important task, which includes creating and implementing quality planning and assurance and controlling accordingly. It is also known as total quality management, that is TQM. There are two philosophies given by different scientists who have worked for quality management. The first one is W. Edward Deming philosophy. The philosophy of quality management given by W. Edward Deming gives, according to Deming, by implementing certain rules of management, organizations can be improved the quality of product and reduce the cost of product simultaneously. Reduction of cost may include things like reduction of waste production, reducing staff attrition and litigation while simulating increasing customer loyalty. This graph shows his perception towards the quality management. On x-axis there is a time and on y-axis there is quality improvement. During the process we have to take care of all these four things like act, plan, do and check. What does it mean? We will see in next slide. The steps that the cycle follow are first plan, a consumer research methodology which will inform business process components. Second, do. Implement the plan to measure the performance. Check the measurements and report the findings to the decision makers. And last one is act, adjust or correct. Draw a conclusion on the changes that we have done for the betterment of quality. Deming has given the 14 points for quality management, which consist of a set of guidelines for managers looking to transform business effectiveness. These 14 points are given as follows. First point is create consistency of purpose for improvement of product and service. Second, follow a new philosophy. Third, discontinue dependence on mass inspections. Fourth, cease the practice of awarding business on price tags. Fifth, strive always to improve the production and service of the organization. Next, introduce new and modern methods of on-the-job training. Devise modern methods of supervision. Let go fear for production and quantitative things. Destroy barriers among the staff areas. Remove the barriers that burden the workers for working. Dispose of the numerical goals created for the workers' satisfaction. Eliminate work standards and numerical quotas. Devise vigorous education and training programs for training the staff members for qualitative product. The cumulative top management that will strive towards these goals will help to improve the quality and move further for organizations. Drawbacks of this philosophy are given as follows. Deficiency of the constancy of purpose factor to plan a product or service. Organizations giving importance to short-term profits only. Employing personal review system to evaluate performance, merit ratings, and annual reviews for the employees. It creates constant job hopping from the employees. Use of visible figures only for management with little or no consideration of figures that are unknown or unknowable. Excessive cost for liability factors. An overload of medical cost on personnel in organization. The next philosophy is given by Joseph M. Juran, which is known as Juran's philosophy regarding management of quality. Juran delivered track to focus instead on the human dimensions of quality management. He laid emphasis on importance of educating and training managers and staff members. For Juran, the root cause of quality issue was the resistance to change and human relations problems between management and staff members. His philosophy effectively works for the service-related sectors, industries, and not for the manufacturing or process industries. The Juran quality trilogy. The Juran given three quality trilogies such as quality planning. This is a process that involves creating awareness of the necessity to improve, setting certain goals and ways to reach those goals. This process is important in the management's commitment towards quality and recommends qualified staffs for that. Second, quality control. This is a process to develop the methods to test the products for their quality deviations from the standard requirement of product, and it will require change and improvement day to day. Third trilogy is quality improvement. This is a process that involves the constant drive to perfection. Quality improvements needs to be constituently introduced, problems must be diagnosed to the root causes to develop solution. The management must analyze the processes and the system and report back with recognition and praise when things are done right and appreciable. Three steps to progress of quality improvement. Juran also introduced the three steps to progress for quality improvement. First, accomplish improvements that are structured on regular basis with commitments and sense of urgency. Second is build an extensive training program. Third, cultivate commitment and leadership at the higher echelons of management. 10 steps to improve the quality by Juran. First, establish awareness for the need to improve and the opportunities thereafter. The second need is set goals for improvement of product. Third step is organize to meet the goals that have been set. Fourth step is provide training to employee for betterment of quality. Fifth, implement project aimed to solving problems of the community. Sixth, report progress for the improvement of quality. Seventh step for quality improvement is give recognition. Eighth step for improvement of quality is communicating results at every stage of work. Ninth step is related to keep score for every activity and every staff member who is doing work properly. The 10th and last step is regarding maintaining momentum by building improvement into the company's regular system. Thank you.